folks, this is David Kwan here, and I'm here to talk about Mario Kart 8. I know I'm really late to the party, but I'm always late to the party with games, so get used to that. But Mario Kart 8, so when I first started the game, I don't know, it took me a while to really grow to like this game. For whatever reason, I guess it might have been, before I played this game, I was playing on my Vita a lot. I was playing Modern Racers on there, which is an interesting game. That's a game too. I'm not sure if I like really like this game. I'm not sure if I'm like really frustrated with this game or just like it's meh, whatever. So it's kind of mix of emotions as I play that game. And I guess Mario Kart 8, the first thing that stands out really is it's a beautiful game. It's super gorgeous, a lot of colors. Seriously, just so many colors, and that's in. Even more than like Mod Nation Racers, and when I was playing that game, I was like, this is a game with a lot of colors and a lot of customization. And then I'm just thrown into Mario Kart 8 and just like, holy crap, this game just boom, you know, it's just really visually mesmerizing. And just a lot of stuff going on in the background with the anti-gravity, you're flying in the air, your kart just changes, and a lot of the facial animations that the camera zooms in on with some of the, you know, your favorite Mario characters. There is characters. Okay, so that's probably one thing that still kind of bugs me a little bit. There aren't really that many characters. So you have 30 characters, about 30, excluding the people that you have to buy to download, which includes Link, Dry Bowser, Villager, this dog character, whatnot. So I guess you can buy more characters, that's nice, but the other characters are, so you have some of the iconic ones, you know, your typical Mario, Wario, Luigi, Waluigi, Donkey Kong, Peach, Daisy, Bowser, and Yoshi, and Shy Guys there, things like that. But then you have all these slew of baby characters, what the heck, baby Mario, baby Peach, who asked for these? You know, baby Koopa's kids. So I know there's a lot of Koopa kids, but I don't understand the big deal for that. And then as you unlock more characters, you're like, oh, I have a new character. And then like, no, wait, what? I get a golden version of Peach? Okay. So just it seems like the extra characters are just a lot of clones and a lot of babies, which I don't feel too hot about. But it is really interesting, a lot of the, with each Mario Kart iteration, they try to bring back the old courses and re-update them. And with Mario Kart 8 mechanics, I think a lot of them are really cool. The original SNES one, where it's just like a figure 8 course, that one's pretty cool. It doesn't really do any anti-gravity stuff, but I think that's great. It doesn't need anti-gravity stuff. That one's just really good to play, and it's really good updated. And The two updated courses that are just like, what the heck, you know, are Toad's Road, you know, the highway. That one's more, it's just really boring. I don't know why they decided to include it or update it. If you want to play the more fun version, go play the N64 one. And then Rainbow Road, the way they did it, I don't really like it. So Rainbow Road N64 version, it's a really long course. But in Mario Kart 8, they decided to break it up into three parts. So each lap is one of the parts. So it ends so quickly now. So the problem with the original N64 Rainbow Road is that it's so long. And I feel like the problem with the Mario Kart 8 version of the N64 Rainbow Road is that it's too short. It just ends so quickly. And so to get from 12th place to 1st place just feels like such a challenge, just because it's such, you have to do it in such a short amount of time. Now, there's another Rainbow Road that of Mario Kart 8 Rainbow Road. That one is like, oh, that one's a frustrating course because there's so many ways to fall up the edge if you don't correctly kind of drift and corner well. That's another thing about Mario Kart 8. I think it requires skill in some ways to be able to hit the. Hit the R button. Hit the R button at the right time to be able to drift. And as you're drifting, you continue to gather that spark, And when you get enough spark, you let go, and there's a little added boost. The longer you hold the spark, the longer the boost, the longer you're able to boost. So that's really interesting, and how the courses are tricky and Kirby to be designed for that. And the higher difficulty levels, you know, 150cc, 100cc, that really matters. I think that's really great. And also, this Mario Kart, compared to probably the previous ones, requires more skill, although there's still a lot of luck involved, still a lot of like hair-raising, frustrating moments at the very last moment of the race. But one of the things is, you get hit by a shell, or you get hit by a thunder, or by a blue shell, or even you even fall off a course, you can get back into the race really quickly compared to the other ones. So that's really cool. And it's really interesting how the power-ups work. If you're in the first place, the only thing you're gonna get is banana coins and a green shell. If you're in the second and third place, whatever, you're gonna get a lot more stuff, but less of the ones that affect everyone. So if you're in second, third, fourth, and fifth, you're gonna get red shells, green shells, a little sound blaster thing. So that's a new addition to Mario Kart 8. Apparently, I didn't know this until I was, you know, watching some reviews, the sound blaster thing. So if you get it in third place or whatever, and you keep it and you get to first place, and somebody shoots that blue shell at you, which, you know, just goes all the way through, and then without fail, that blue shell is going to attack the first place person. If, when that blue shell is about to stomp you, use that sound blaster thing that negates the blue shell. So there's a counteract to the blue shell, which is really cool, but the thing is, you have to get the sound blaster in second or third place, and then get to first place. And once you're in first place, you have to be doing really well. I feel like there's less rubber banding in this game, which is a surprise, because Mario Kart as a franchise has always been kind of known for rubber banding, frustrating rubber banding, but that's good. The only thing is, on the higher difficulty levels, it's like the game really hates you. So you're doing really good. You're in first place for a while, like da-da-da-da-da, I'm going to win this race. And like the last 10 seconds of the entire race, something happens. You know, you get hit by a red shell, you get hit by a blue shell, something is going to happen. And you better cross your fingers, the freaking A, that you're able to go back to racing time and still maintain that first place. Because otherwise, you're doing amazing the entire race, and then the last second screws you over and you just got third place or second place. Like, what? You know, that's the kind of the frustrating stuff that happens in Mario Kart 8. The level design is really cool for the most part, but I think some parts are still, like, Wario Stadium, there's this one part where the road kind of curves off, and it becomes like these, you know, the wire cages in the Mario games that Mario used to climb on. It turns sideways, so your car does anti-gravity, pulls sideways. The first corner is easy, but right after that first corner is a really sharp left corner. To make that is super difficult with a heavier character like Wario, Bowser, or Donkey Kong. Try to do that with those characters. It's just, like, so frustrating. Rainbow Road, the Mario Kart 8 version, is probably the most challenging course, I think, in the game. And yeah, it's but like, the challenge is there. It's a really fun game, challenge-wise. Some of my gripes is just the characters, really. And the battle mode, which everybody says is true. It's not really a battle mode because you're just racing around with three balloons. And once in a while, you come across another player who fake going against you, and it's just kind of like, who's gonna hit trigger first, and it's not very fun. Online's good. I play some online matches. There's hardly any lag, and it's been able to kind of match quickly. I don't have any friends on the Wii U, so whatever. I guess I should start having friends online on the Wii U, but even if I do, there's no chat system, apparently. There's no way to kind of gather friends and lobby up, so that's a bummer, but it doesn't really affect me because I don't have any friends on the Wii U, I just play. But it's really interesting. You know, I'm disappointed that, you know, 16 courses are, I have to buy them for $12, which I'm not going to, and, you know, that also unlocks the characters, more characters who are more than just clones and babies, seriously. Although I would just like to see more characters. It doesn't really matter that much. The who you pick doesn't really affect the game that much unless you pick the heavier characters. The carts that you unlock are really cool. Like, there's so many, like, this charming aspects about the cars. There's a yacht. Okay, so this is spoiler. I guess if you haven't played the game already, but I feel like a lot of people are into Mario Kart, so whatever. But, spoiler. Yoshi bike, you know, the dry boat that Bowser... I mean, there are character-specific carts and bikes and things like that, and you get to choose whether you want to ride a bike or a cart or a monster bike or a Donkey Kong bike. Like, it's great. I really like that kind of customization. So that's Mario Kart 8 in a nutshell. It's a really fun game that grew on me. Just wish kind of there was, I don't know, it feels like it's fun, so I keep coming back to it because eventually it's fun. But overall content-wise, there's just the characters, the customizable carts and cart parts, what have you. The customizable cart parts are not really that big of a deal anyway. There's not that much, and it's not really that much. But the carts themselves are really cool. And then the levels, 16 levels, I think, courses, which for the most part, most of them are really cool, really well done, and the various branching paths takes a lot of skills to get used to. And although on I think a few courses I've kind of mastered them more now, so it's just like, oh yeah, I'm gonna take the shortcut now, which is a lot easier for me now. But some of the courses are just like, oh my god, you know. But only because the last freaking 30 seconds of the lap, like, something will screw you over. It's bound to happen, and that sucks. And you just really hate whoever is second or third place, because it's always the same computer characters who are the second or third. So that hasn't changed about Mario Kart. That's always been the same about Mario Kart. And yeah, so that's going to be the same here. Anyway, that's my video on Mario Kart 8. Hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.